I'm a giant, Om Namah Shivaya twice. Please repeat after me. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Om Namah Shivaya.
Is guided meditation. which you just have to listen. There is nothing to be done. There is just to be. To be the natural self that I am. And therefore, there is nothing to be done. There is nothing to be accomplished. Nothing to be achieved. Vedanta teaches that I already am what I am trying to become. Therefore, there is no becoming involved. I don't have to try to become someone else. I don't want to achieve something to be successful. I am already successful. I have to see this fact. This meditation is of the nature of seeing what is. There is no new experience, no new sensation, no new accomplishment. Just being what I am, seeing what I am. That is why this meditation calls for a giving up of my tendency to do something. I am generally oriented towards doing something. I am oriented towards becoming something. I am oriented towards accomplishing something. All of these tendencies are based on my assumption about myself, on my judgment about myself. That I am not what I am trying to become. I have to become something or someone to be all right. I have to achieve something to be all right. I have to become successful. Because I am not successful as I am. This is my judgment or conclusion about myself. These judgments or conclusions about the self. Prompt me to do what I am doing. Vedanta says that I am already accomplished. It is the accomplishment of what is already accomplished. Meaning that I don't need to accomplish anything to be all right. I don't need to achieve anything to be all right. I don't want to become anything, someone, to be all right. I am all right as I am. I have to see that fact. Seeing or knowledge requires that I let go all the tendencies to do something. Knowledge and action cannot go together. The very tendency to do something, the very tendency to become something, involves negation of what I am. Therefore, what is necessary is accepting myself as I am. I am all right as I am. In spite of all the limitations, I recognize that there are many limitations, many shortcomings in me. My body has many limitations, many shortcomings. But that is how the body is meant to be. The body has limitations of strength. The body has limitations of health. The body has limitations. I am all right in spite of these limitations. It is not that I will become all right when my body becomes perfect. Presently, I am judging myself based on my body. Body is healthy, I am okay. Body is not healthy, I am not okay. My being all right is in spite of the body being what it is. Just as there are limitations in the body, there are limitations in the mind. I have limitations in understanding. The mind has limitations in the memory. The mind has limitations in terms of grasping. The mind has limitations in terms of various impulses. It is true that the mind has these and many other limitations. I am all right in spite of the limitations of the mind. It is not that I will become all right when my mind becomes perfect. That can never happen. The body cannot become perfect. The mind cannot become perfect. My performance cannot be perfect. My understanding cannot be perfect. Nothing in this personality can be perfect. The body, mind, sense complex. Is my nature imperfect? I can bring about some improvements. But regardless of what I do with the body, regardless of what I do with the sense organs, regardless of what I do with my mind, they will all remain imperfect. If I judge myself on the basis of my body, I can never be perfect. If I judge myself on the basis of sense organs, I cannot be perfect. If I judge myself on the basis of the mind, I cannot be perfect. The Upanishad says, I am perfect. The Upanishad says, I am perfect as I am. I don't become perfect. That means I am all right as I am. In spite of all the limitations of the body. I am all right as I am. In spite of the limitations at the level of the sense organs. I am all right as I am. In spite of the limitations in the mind. Therefore, what I need to do is to let go my tendency tendency to become perfect. I need to let go my tendency to achieve something. I need to let go my tendency to change something. Nothing, whatever is required to be done. And therefore, all that is required is to give up my natural tendency to do something. I need to give up my natural tendency to become something. I need to give up my normal tendency to change myself, change other things. Everything is all right as it is. Because I'm the witness of the body. And therefore, I am not the body. I am the witness of the sense organs. And therefore, I am not the sense organs. I am the witness of the mind. And therefore, I am not the mind. Since I am not the body, it does not matter how the body is. It does not matter to me how the body is. It does not matter to me how the sense organs are. It does not matter to me how even the mind is. Let them be what they are. Let the body be what it is. Let the sense organs be what they are. Let the mind be what it is. I accept my body. I accept the sense organs. I accept the mind as they are. I accept my body as it is. I accept my sense organs as they are. I accept my mind as it is. Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. Chidananda Rupa Shivoham, Shivoham. Chidananda Rupam, Shivoham, Shivoham. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate.